You're watching The Big Story on Mirror Now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Let's take a look at the top headlines. Leather traders and workers worry as the GST approaches leather products to be taxed at 28% under the GST, which is the highest tax bracket of luxury goods. Meanwhile, shoppers across the country enjoy huge discounts from retailers. Black Eid in Ballabgarh's Kandavli village. Residents protest the slow police investigation in the case where a 16-year-old boy was stabbed to death on a moving train 4 days ago. Haryana police announces 1 lakh rupee reward for any credible information in the case. Inconsolable family given 5 lakh rupee compensation.
जब वो पूरी फिल्म को देखेंगे मे बी आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट कुछ बातें हैं उनको ठीक नहीं लग रही और अगर नहीं लग रही तो हम उसको चेंज कर देंगे बट आई थिंक जब पूरा फिल्म देखेंगे सो दे विल अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड होपफुली एवरीथिंग विल बी गुड.
शाहरुख खान स्पीक्स अप ऑन द कंट्रोवर्सी ऑफ हिज अपकमिंग मूवी जब हैरी मेट सेजल. सेज द वर्ड इंटरकॉर्स मेंट नो डिसरिस्पेक्ट. अर्लियर सीबीएफसी चीफ पलाज नीलानी said that he would pass the word intercourse in Khan's next Uncensored if Mirror Now could get 1 lakh votes. Indrani Mukherjee charged with rioting, unlawful assembly and assault on public servant after she leads 200 women prisoners in a protest in Baikala jail. Now Mukherjee, a socialite and former TV channel owner, is in jail on charges of murdering her daughter Sheena Bora. Celebrations across the country on the occasion of Eid. The festival marks the culmination of fasting and the end of the holy month of Ramzan. Straight up to our big story, attacked, lynched and murdered. 4 days after 16-year-old Junaid was allegedly stabbed and killed by a mob on a train in Ballabgarh, Haryana, investigations continue to be slow. Only one person has been arrested by the police so far. Junaid and his two brothers were attacked by a mob on the train for alleged consumption of beef. Now, Junaid was reportedly beaten and stabbed to death. His brothers were grievously injured. The brothers were allegedly refused help as well by railway officials. Residents of Kandavli village where Junaid lived in the meantime are not celebrating Eid. Villagers are sporting black bands in solidarity with the victims of this gruesome incident. While the entire nation is celebrating Eid, there is one village in particular in Ballabgarh which certainly is not celebrating Eid because their own villager was lynched to death. I'm joined by a lot of villagers here in Kadivali in Haryana's Ballabgarh area, where you've seen how they're sporting a black band to mourn the death of their villager and also protesting against the lack of any action that has been taken against those perpetrators of crime who lynched a 16-year-old to death. Let me go across to some villagers here.
See, this is not a single village who not celebrating Eid. We have a lot of villages around that village, near about the 15 or 20 villages, they are not celebrating their Eid. They are doing peaceful protest with that black band on their arms.
ऐसा नहीं है कि घटना पहली बार हुई है. इससे पहले भी बहुत सारी घटनाएं हो चुकी हैं. तो गवर्नमेंट इस चीज़ का इनिशिएट ले कि इस तरह की घटनाएं आगे ना हो.
There you have it. These are the kind of voices that you are getting from this particular village where a lot of people here knew Junaid, the 16-year-old boy who was lynched to death. And they say that they have a lot of aspirations that this boy had. He was a very charming boy who was always smiling all the time. And they still cannot recover from the loss that they're experiencing at the moment. In Ballabgarh, this is Apurva Sridhar for Mirror Now. Investigation team also reached Asothi to talk to the villagers to find leads. Listen in.
देखिए, इंडियन रेलवे इज अ वास्ट नेटवर्क. 66,000 किलोमीटर चलते हैं. ट्रेनें लोकल्स हैं, कलकत्ता में चलते हैं, मुंबई में चलते हैं, दिल्ली में चलते हैं. अनफॉर्चुनेट इंसिडेंट है, कोई डिनाइल केस में बात नहीं है, पर इसको कैसे इम्प्रूव किया जाए उस पर एक कार्रवाई हो रही है. और कैसे इसको इम्प्रूव किया जाए, बेसिकली कोई भी क्राइम में पैसेंजर्स का सपोर्ट बहुत ज़रूरी होता है. हर एक जगह पे सिक्योरिटी नहीं लगाई जा सकती। अब जब तक पूरे देश में हर एक ट्रेनों में कैमरा ना लग जाए तब तक उन चीज़ों को वो भी कैमरा कभी कोई क्राइम को रोक नहीं सकता है, वो इन्वेस्टिगेशन में ही काम आएगा। पब्लिक सपोर्ट, पब्लिक का हेल्प खासकर इन सब चीज़ों में बहुत ज़रूरत है। पर जो भी इंसिडेंट हुआ है अनफॉर्चुनेट इंसिडेंट्स है और उसको रेलवेज, इंडियन रेलवेज अपने साइड से स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के साथ, जीआरपी के साथ, आरपीएफ जीआरपी मिलकर इसको कैसे इम्प्रूव किया जाए उस पर हम लोग अभी आगे कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं।
अभी तक हमने एक अक्यूज्ड रमेश को अरेस्ट किया हुआ है जो 3 दिन का रिमांड पे चल रहा है। इसके अतिरिक्त हमारी 4 टीमें हैं जो हम लगातार पैसेंजर से अपना संपर्क बना रहे हैं ताकि हम अन्य अक्यूज्ड तक भी पहुंच पाएंगे। और इसके अतिरिक्त हम आज मैं गांव अपनी टीम पूरी SHO के साथ अन्य टीम के साथ में हमारे गाँव सब टीम आए हैं। हमने यहाँ भी अनुरोध किया है, गाँव वालों से भी अनुरोध कर रहे हैं कि इसमें हमारी जो जायज इमदाद हमारे को करें। और इसके अलावा हमारी जो टीम है हमने कुछ डेली पैसेंजर्स को आइडेंटिफाई किया है, उनसे हमारी पूछताछ चल रही है।
We are from all the possible angles and daily suspected people are being interrogated and hopefully more arrest will be made in this case. The incident happened in moving train and in public view also. So it is there is every possibility that somebody might have made some videography or photography. So that will help in the investigation of the case and that will be a very important clue also and important piece of evidence also. So we have announced this reward and still we are hoping that we will get some information from the public.
On the big story now, we're joined in by ND Pancholi, PUCL president, on the phone line now. Mr. Pancholi, this is a question we're asking. Why is the investigation so slow in this case? Only one arrest made so far.
You see, that is the problem with our police, because they always see what kind of political group is in power and they always the kind of atmosphere which has been created in the country, that hatred against Muslim and the ill will against Muslim, so that also affect them. And the police is not independent. In fact, it is the political this power under which they are functioning. So it is their job that they must energize the police. इतना करप्ट सिस्टम है हमारी पुलिस का अभी तक, मतलब ये तो पुलिस को सब कुछ कर सकती है, सब कुछ पता है, मैं तो समझता हूँ उनको पता है, है ना, लेकिन कुछ एंगल्स ऐसे हैं कि वो इसमें बड़े स्लो। अगर कोई इंसिडेंट हो जाता है, कोई बम ब्लास्ट हो जाता है कि उसका पता ही नहीं लगता किसने किया, लेकिन एक दूसरे दिन अरेस्ट भी हो जाती है, तीसरे दिन सब कुछ हो जाता है। अगर कोई मुस्लिम इन्वॉल्व है एक्यूज तो फौरन उसको अरेस्ट हो जाता है। लेकिन इस तरह के जो एलिमेंट हैं, जो हिंदू राष्ट्र बनाना चाहते हैं, जो गौ रक्षक के नाम पे वो करते हैं, वो तो खुलेआम, मतलब अब वहाँ पहलू खान का जो हुआ था उसमें खुलेआम, मतलब सब लोग जानते हैं, उनके वीडियो भी हैं, बट मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर नॉट अरेस्टेड। तो ये पुलिस का जो सिस्टम है, करप्शन।
इनफैक्ट मिस्टर पंचोली, डू स्टे विद अस, वी आल्सो हैव कॉलिन गोंजाल्वेस, सीनियर एडवोकेट, जॉइनिंग अस ऑन द फोन लाइन एज वेल। मिस्टर गोंजाल्वेस, टेल अस दिस नाउ, इट्स बीन 4 days, द इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज एक्सट्रीमली स्लो, ओनली वन अरेस्ट मेड सो फार, बट इन अ केस लाइक दिस वेयर द विक्टिम हियर वाज लिंच्ड, कुड द केस गेट डाइल्यूटेड देन?
See, two things can happen. That is to say, if we are alert and if society is ready to fight the case, we can win this case. But the general tendency is that these people have political support at the highest level. Persons who engage in lynching, gau rakshaks, killing people, hanging people. There was a meeting in Goa recently and there a young sadhvi said that if anyone does anything like this referring to Muslims, they should be hanged. And it is reported in all the newspapers. Now, if political people at the highest levels are encouraging murder, then you can understand that the police are not going to follow up with any case unless a lawyer takes this case seriously and fights for the family of the victim, then justice can be done. But we must take these people to court. And when these people who encourage people to hang other people are arrested and put behind bars,
all the dumb will be out of them, you know, all the hawa will be taken out of them. That's what we should do. We should fight back.
This is murder. I mean, despite the fact that the victim was, beaten up to death by nearly 15 people, a mob on a train over 45 kilometers, no action has been taken so far. The investigation is extremely slow.
And I can tell you, because there'll be political interference immediately. Some politician, some minister, some sadhvi, some, you know, Gaurakshak fellow, some Hindutva element will phone the police station, will phone the SHO and say, ye apna aadmi hai, kuch mat karo. And they will stop the investigation. That is the state of our police today. And what can they do? When the political establishment, the present government, is encouraging these things at the highest level, what can they do? So we must fight, we must take the initiative into our own hands, not rely on the police, file the case in the court, pursue the case, ask for an independent investigation, not a simple police investigation. Ask for an independent investigation and proceed ahead to punish these people.
Mr. Gonzalez, they're saying that an independent investigation must take place. Do stay with us. Mr. Pancholi, tell us this now here. In this case, there are several lapses that have come to the forefront. The victim's brothers have also alleged now that railway officials did not help them.
That is a very sad part of the story, because the atmosphere which has been slowly and slowly building up, you know, in so many incidents, that gov protection and Muslim, the hatred and ill will against the Muslims, or in such cases, most of the, because generally real culprits are not apprehended. Some innocent, the people, the police, what they generally do, they catch hold of some innocent people, and then after some time, their cases are not proved, they are released. But the real offenders, when they know that nothing would be done against them, so they would plan further attacks. They are going to plan further attacks. So it is the
Right, we also have Vikram Singh, former DGP of UP, joining us on the phone line. Mr. Singh, tell us this now. In a case like this, where there are several lapses, we just spoke about the fact that railway officials allegedly did not help the victim's brothers at that point in time when the incident actually took place, and comment on the fact that the investigation is extremely slow in this case.
In fact, help did not come from any quarter. The railway helpline was dysfunctional. The police helpline, the emergency helplines was dysfunctional. To the contrary, the people who were there in the compartment had a lot to do, yet they chose to remain mute and silent spectators. I would rather that these so-called spectators in the compartment who obstructed the safe passage of the victims should also be charged under 120B of the criminal conspiracy, and should be charged of murder and criminal assault. Now, under these circumstances, I do not agree with the earlier caller that it is difficult for them, the police, to arrest the accused, because here the evidence is incontrovertible. Overwhelming evidence is there. But you have a point there. The SODRP Surat Singh is on record to say that what could the police do? I mean, if you are not equal to the task, it's better that you shed your uniform and allow somebody more capable to wear that uniform, be observed and be accountable to the conscience and to the constitution. In your case, Surat Singh, you are not only not accountable to the constitution, I dare say that you are not accountable to your conscience also and allowed this to happen. And then you are brazen enough to say that what can the police do in such cases? It is a riotous situation.
Also, Mr. Singh, tell us this now. When we caught up with the IG of RPF, he of course said that Indian Railways is a vast network and passengers must help, and that they can't deploy security everywhere.
Nobody expects them to deploy security everywhere. But what they do expect when they pay for the tickets is to give a secure environment. Nobody expects you to have a magic wand, but they do expect you to have absolute basic deterrent against the criminals, and the free-for-all atmosphere should not be prevailing. It's a very scary kind of a statement given by the IGRPF and a very irresponsible. It has said we have seen this by prompt arrest and prompt prosecution of these people who have perpetrated this horrific crime, and we'll see if it doesn't happen in future. What are you doing about SOGRP Surat Singh? Are you to condone his irresponsible statement? I don't think the IGRPF 2 should be complimented for what he said. I don't.
I'd like to toss this question to Mr. Gonzalez. Come in on this. We know, of course, that in this case, there are several lapses. The police did not help. The railway officials did not help. In fact, the railway official here saying that the Indian Railways is a vast network and we can't deploy security everywhere. But also, what happens in a case like this where there are silent spectators?
Not only silent spectators, there are people who booked and reserved seats in and around the place where the incident took place. So we have the names, address, telephone numbers of the persons who were sitting in the compartment at that time. It's not that I can't do anything. You must immediately recover the names of the passengers in that compartment at that point of time. You have to interrogate all of them. You have to take all their statements, etc. Now, I don't expect the police to do anything or the railways to do anything. So what the family must do is to go to the High Court immediately and ask for a special investigation team consisting of officers from outside the state and headed by a very independent, and there are many like that, very independent officer who will take all these gundas to task. And it's possible, it's doable, it's not that nothing can be done. So there's no point moaning and groaning about the present railway administration and the police. They are utterly useless and they must be expected to be useless. I don't expect them to do a single thing in this. So I don't think we should waste our time on this. Go to the High Court, get the SIT appointed, get an independent officer appointed and pursue these gundas.
Right, Anuja Kapoor also joins us on the phone line now. Anuja Kapoor, tell us this. Do you also believe that an independent investigation must take place in a case like this where there are multiple lapses?
That's something, yes, it could be possible, but that's something secondary. What we need to understand first is, like, the laws which are there already. SIT, you know, even if you put SIT, what will be the fun of it? You know how the corruption and how the... You know, I would not say that totally all of them are corrupted officers, but you know they can be. They can appoint the officers which they have an influence. So what is the point of SIT, tell me? So rather than go for a state CID, which could be looking up into the matter individually and independently, don't you think? So because I don't believe in CBI and I don't believe in SIT, because they both can be arranged and fabricated and corrupted. So, I think...
Then what is the possible solution? What do you suggest must be done?
I would say that, you know, we should go for state CID and moreover look into the matter of mob lynching. As the lynching which is happening day in and day out is basically the political will which is trying to manipulate the mob, where they are religious issues which are coming up again and again. And trying to invade, and it's just near the Eid, they are trying to manifest this, that they are having this beef and they are having this and that, and to the children, and they're trying to take out their caps and they're throwing it down on the floor. You know, it's called hurting, and it should be dealt definitely strongly, but it also needs a proper kind of an investigation where we are talking about, which we just rightly said, but what from my side, I think a state CID should be looking into it.
Also comment on the fact that there are multiple lapses in this case, in the sense that railway officials, for instance, the victim's brothers alleged that the railway officials did not come forward and help at all. The railway officials, on the other hand, say that Indian Railways is a vast network and they cannot deploy security everywhere.
What else they would say? Because they could see that the power of a mob, what they will do? Because the incident will come and go. But they will be still there, right? So they can come back and they can take the revenge of him or her or whatever the situations are, their family. So why would they see anything? Because there is no witness protection. And why would they come up? So they stay like mum. They want to keep quiet. They believe that they have not seen anything. They were not there. It is not their duty. And if something has happened or not, they don't want to comment on it. because they don't want to do it because sab kuch chalta hai aur sab kuch bikta hai. So this is when the mentality is, how do you expect that they would even stand up for this? Why would they?
Vikram Singh, come in on this. How do you think we need to address the problem of mob lynching? In this case, several lapses also have come in the forefront. Do you also believe that an independent investigation must take place?
I would say so, but in case I wouldn't be so pessimistic. I know the situation is, but I wouldn't be so pessimistic. There have not been very many cases, but those that have happened are bad enough. Let us make exemplary cases out of them. Put them in a fast track court, have special prosecutors, and ensure that each and every one of them ends up in a conviction, and ensure that they're convicted and there are no acquittals. By that, you send the signal, and those people who see so irresponsibly that what can we do, Indian Railways is the huge and the largest in the world, I would say that if it's large, I would have expected that you also to give a befitting reply to the goons and to the criminals, but you have not. And the very fact that you seem to be pessimistic, as also the fact that you are unequal to the task assigned to you, you should be shifted to office work so that at the moment you feel that you are equal to the task, then be given field responsibility. Otherwise, I think you need to go for a tutorial or for a refresher course before you officers like you are unleashed on the public.
In fact, one quick question from Mr. Gonzalez before we wrap up this discussion. Mr. Gonzalez, tell us this now. You mentioned that an independent investigation has to take place and that is the only way. But this is a case of a cold-blooded murder that we're talking about, and a simple investigation is also not taking place.
Correct. We don't expect an investigation to take place. That is why in the case of murder or any serious crime, we want an independent investigation by the police to catch these hooligans and these Hindutva elements and put them behind bars. That's what we want to do. And let me say one more thing. I don't agree that the police, the railway officials could do nothing. I don't agree that there's a big mob, so what do these poor people do? I don't agree that sab kuch chalta hai. The time has come, and I believe we Indians are capable of it. If five of these railway officials had immediately called the police, and if they had gone to the site and struggled to prevent the attack, if five of them had shown courage, forget five, if two of them had shown courage, these are hooligans and gundas and cowards. So if they are confronted with officials and policemen, who knows, maybe you could have stopped it. So let us not have this, you know, sab kuch chalta hai attitude. We Indians must stand up against these Hindutva elements. We must stand up and speak, even if we are alone. Even if you are one person against the mob, we should stand up and speak. Whatever the consequences, we must stand up and speak. We must get out of this, sab kuch chalta hai, what could they do? We must get out of this excuses.
Absolutely. 4 days on and only one arrest made so far. I thank all of you for joining us here on Mirror Now. Now, we also caught up with Junaid Khan's grieving family and his teacher. Listen in.
2:30 बजे हम सब माँ बेटे इकट्ठा हो गए. मैंने उन लोग खाना बनाया उनने भी खाए, मैंने भी खाए. वह नमाज पढ़न लू चले गए, मैं रह गई. फिर वह के बाद चले गए वे. फिर रोजा को टाइम हो गया, दिन ही ढड़गो मन के अब आएंगे. जब आए रोजो खोलो, मैं पहले ही नू कह रही मेरी जान खिंच रही हाथ पामन की. तो फोन आयो, पतो ना कस को आयो. जब मैं नमाज पढ़ रही, मैंने कही कहा होगो नू बालकन को झगड़ो होगो, चक्कू मार दियो.
एक पकड़ लिया था उन्होंने, अरेस्ट भी कर लिया है एक. मैं अब सुनाई में आई, दूसरा भी पकड़ लिया कोई. उसकी सिस्टर नहीं हुई मुझे तो. वो
जो 6 लोगों को उन्होंने हिरासत में लिया था, उनको छोड़ दिया क्योंकि उनका चेहरा नहीं मिल रहा था. आपके लड़के ने कहा कि ये वो नहीं है जिन्होंने अटैक किया.
नहीं, वो बच्चे क्या पिछाड़ेंगे जी, 1.5 घंटे के अंदर अंदर उनको तो जान बचानी भारी होगी. उनको तो जो मारा जा रहा है, चक्कुओं से मारा जा रहा, वो पहचानेंगे क्या उसको? वो पहले ही डरे हुए हैं. जो पुलिस उनको अपने आधार पर, अपने टारगेट पर उनको पकड़े, जो और बाकी हैं, जब एक पकड़ लिया वही सारी चैन वही बता देगा.
आप ये देखिए, जो भीड़ थी वो 15 से 20 की थी. आपके लड़के ने एफआईआर में भी मेंशन किया था. आपको क्या लग रहा है कि ये यहाँ के लोकल लोग थे कि बाहर के लोग थे, और ये मैंने आपसे पहले भी ये सवाल पूछा था कि
नहीं, वो बाहर के लोग नहीं है, लोकल ही हैं, पलवल के आसपास के।
लेकिन उनकी पहचान?
पहचान तो हो ही जाएगी उनकी, मेरे बच्चों जो पहचान बुलाती है पुलिस उनको। अब किसी को ऐसे के तो वो घबराए वो बच्चे।
आखिरी बार कब बुलाया था आपके बेटे?
कल भी गए थे,
5-7 साल पहले मैं उसको पढ़ाता था, मेरे पास पढ़ता था, वो बहुत अच्छा खूबसूरत बच्चा था और मेरे पास उसने कलाम पाक पढ़ी थी, फिर मेरे पास से पढ़ गए, वो आगे पहुंच गया दिल्ली, अब दिल्ली पढ़ता था वो, तो वहाँ ईद की खुशी के लिए कपड़े वगैरह, सेंट टोपी वगैरह, मिसवाक वगैरह लेने के लिए गए थे वो। जब लेने के लिए वापस आए थे तो तुगलकाबाद में गुंडे चढ़े थे 15-20 आदमी, तो उन्होंने उन पर उनको छेड़ा, टोपी ओढ़ रखी, मुल्ला कटल लाओ, तुम्हारी टोपी उतारी जाए, तुम्हारी दाढ़ी नोच ली जाए, तो उन्होंने ऐसा तंग किया उन बच्चों को, उन बच्चों को नीचे लुटा के उनको लात मारी थी और घूसा मारे थे, और आगे आहिस्ता आहिस्ता बल्लभगढ़ आया था, बल्लभगढ़ आगे 2-3 बच्चे उतर गए, जो उतरने की कोशिश कर रहे थे वो वापस खींच लिए, वापस खींच कर जब बल्लभगढ़ से पार उतरे तो उनके चाकू घुसे दिए।
बहुत होनहार लड़का था जी, वो बहुत बेहतरीन हाफिज था कुरान का, और आगे भी बहुत कुछ करना था उसको, ना वो मौलवी बनना चाहिए था उसको, मुफ्ती बनना था उसको, और कहता मैं बड़े मिस्र इमाम बनूंगा, उसके सारे सपने जो है ना चकराचूर हो गए। हम तो वहाँ ये चाहते हैं कि हमें इंसाफ मिलना चाहिए और जो उन आदमियों को फांसी होनी चाहिए जिन्होंने ऐसा कुछ किया है।
Well, attacked, lynched and murdered 4 days after 16-year-old Junaid was allegedly stabbed and killed by a mob on a train in Ballabgarh, Haryana. Investigations continue to be slow and only one arrest made so far. 4 days on and the entire village is mourning the death of Junaid. Now we ask, when will the state wake up? When will there be accountability? Something that we'll keep a close watch on and continue to track here on Mirror Now. Let's also take a look now at what else is making news from across the nation. First up, Congress took on Prime Minister Modi's key meet with Donald Trump, accusing PM of promoting jingoism. Now, highlighting that the PM was using the US visit as a platform to promote the achievements of the NDA government, Congress claimed that PM Modi was deviating from real issues.
क्या भारत के प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी अमेरिका के राष्ट्रपति से अमेरिका द्वारा 743 मिलियन अमेरिकन डॉलर की मिलिट्री और सिविलियन मदद जो पाकिस्तान को दी जा रही है उसके रोकने के बारे में बात करेंगे?
After being arrested from Coimbatore, retired Justice C.S. Karnan has appealed to West Bengal governor for bail on parole. The retired judge is currently undergoing a treatment at the state-run SSKM hospital. Karnataka BJP chief claimed that a survey will be conducted to look into the ticket distribution of the 2018 assembly polls. The former chief minister predicted an early assembly polls by December. He also claimed that several sitting legislators from rival parties are willing to join the BJP. Indrani Mukherjee, the woman jailed on charges of murdering her daughter Sheena Bora, has also been booked under rioting, unlawful assembly, assault on a public servant and for burning books and wood in prison. Now, Indrani is among 200 women accused by jail officials of rioting after a woman prisoner died in Baikula jail on Friday. A case now has been registered against her after officials found that she had allegedly instigated and organized the protest. And farmers of the steering committee of farmer groups in Maharashtra have expressed their discontent over the state government's move to waive off 34,000 crore rupees as loans for farmers. He has also said that the amount of loan waived off is not enough and that it will not provide any relief to the distressed farmers. And that's a wrap on the big story here on Mirror Now. Stay tuned.